means
that
you tweet.
You tweet
to your friends.
To your friends.
That we're gonna have two.
That we're gonna have two
special guests.
Special guests
at the General Assembly.
At the General Assembly.
Brother. What a blessing for me to be here. I want to thank my dear brother Thomas. Give him another hand. Give him another hand. Voices in the over against the mainstream media, Tavis Smiley, Amy Goodman, and so many others. Give the alternative media brothers and sisters of all colors a hand. Yeah. I want to thank my dear brother Mario, my dear brother Clark, and I want to thank each and every one of you, because each time I come to these gatherings, I am so humbled and I'm so fired up because we're part of a democratic awakening. It was 3 weeks ago the mainstream press said this is just a fad, and now we got 101 cities in the world. We got 75 cities in America, and it's growing every day precisely because people are morally outraged at the wealth inequality. It's just not right that 42% of our precious children of all colors are living in or near poverty in the richest nation of the history of the world. That's a moral disgrace.
Yes.
An obscenity. An ethical abomination. And 1% of the population have 42% of the wealth. 1% of the population had 83% of the income growth in the last 10 years. And the top 10% had 100% of the income growth. What does that mean? It means that poor people, working people, the 99%, found themselves wrestling with wages that are flattened out, stagnating, with the cost going up. Something is wrong in America, and let us be very clear about this. Let us be very clear that this is not anti-America, this is anti-injustice in America. And the best of America has always been those who came along each generation, straighten your backs up and say, we're going to take a stand for something bigger than this, bigger than ourselves.
Yeah.
But we're cutting in a culture where you got this addiction and self-medication and narcissism and hedonism, nothing but cultural weapons of mass distraction that don't want people to think about what's going on and come together. And what's so beautiful about it, we are all colors, we are all cultures, we are all religions. Thank God for our atheistic and agnostic brothers and sisters part of this. We are all classes, we are all civilizations, we are all genders, we are all sexual orientations. Why? Because justice is something bigger than each and every one of us. And don't let anybody tell you that this is about hating anybody. No, not at all. This is what the OJs call a love train. This is what God called a love supreme. Because justice is what love looks like in public, just like democracy is what justice looks like in practice. And we here because we're Democrats. Small D.
Yes.
Small D. And if you're a Democrat, small D, that means you fundamentally believe in the depths of your heart that a brother and sister of any color who's poor, but we're all coming together, then we spill over national boundaries. You got brothers and sisters in Australia occupying, brothers and sisters in Britain, in Ireland, in Asia, in Latin America, in Africa. Oh, yes. This is the U.S. autumn responding to the April spring.
Yeah.
And they're going to have to tell a story about how we came together. Why? Because we are going to attempt to change this country.
Yeah.
Change it for the better.
Right.
And as our dear brother Howard Zinn used to say, oh, we miss brother Howard Zinn.
Yeah.
Oh, we miss brother Howard Zinn. He used to say, dissent is the highest form of patriotism.
Yeah.
The highest form of patriotism. So stay strong, and we will be back at 5 o'clock, because I told them I'm not going into the studio. This is my studio.